वंदेहं श्री गुरु श्री जुता पदकमलं
So here it is said, the Bhagavan was, the Supreme Personality of Godhead is speaking. He is speaking means, he is speaking with all knowledge. His knowledge has no flaw. Our knowledge has many, so many flaws. We commit mistakes. We are illusioned. Sometimes we speak something and at our heart, there is something else. That means you cheat. And our experience, all imperfect, because our senses are imperfect. Therefore, I cannot speak anything to you. If you ask me, Swamiji, then what you are speaking? I am speaking simply what the Supreme Personality Godhead has said. I am just repeating the same words, that's all. Don't think that I am speaking. I am simply an instrument. Real speaker is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is without and within. So what does he say? He says, anāsritam, anāsrita karma phalam, कार्यम कर्म करोति जा सा सन्यासी च योगी च ना निरग्नि न चाक्रिया अनाश्रिता अनाश्रिता मीन्स विदाउट एनी शेल्टर कर्म फलम एवरी वन इज वर्किंग एक्सपेक्टिंग सम रिजल्ट व्हाट एवर यू डू व्हाट You expect some result. Here, Bhagavan says, the Supreme Personality Godhead says, that anyone who works without any shelter of the result, he works. Then, if he does not expect any result, then why does he work? Unless, suppose, I ask somebody, to work this way, then he will expect something, some result, some remuneration, some reward, or some salary. That is the way of working here. But Krishna prescribes the anāsrita karma phalam. One who works without any expectation of result or reward, then why does he work? Karjam, it is my duty. It is my duty. Not with a razor, but as duty. I am duty bound to do this. Karjam karma karotika. In such a way, if somebody works, sasandashi, he is actually in the renounced order of life. There are four stages of life. According to Vedic culture, we have many times explained to you that brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha and sannyasi. Brahmachari means student life, to be trained up in spiritual understanding, Krishna consciousness, fully trained up, he is called brahmachari. Then, after full training, he accepts wife. He gets himself married and lives with family and children, that is called grihastha. Then, after 50 years, he leaves the children alone and gets out of home, accompanied by his wife, and travels in the holy places, that is called vanaprastha, retired life. And at last, he gives up his wife to the care of his children, grown-up children, and he remains alone. And that is called sannyas, a renounced order of life. So these four orders of life there are. Now Krishna says that simply renouncement is not all. Simply renouncement is not all. There must be some duty. Karjam. Karjam means it is my duty. Now what is that duty? He has renounced the family life. He has no more botheration how to maintain his wife and children. Then what is his duty? That duty is very responsible duty. To work for Krishna. Karjam. Karjam means it is the real duty. There are two kinds of duties in our life. One duty is to serve the illusion, and the another duty is to serve the reality. When you serve the reality, that is called real sannyas. And when we serve the illusion, that is called maya. Now, either to serve the reality or to serve the illusion, I am in such a position that I have to serve. My position is not to become the master, but to become the servant. That is my constitution.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.